How you doing, buddy?
I was humiliated on national radio. How do you think I'm doing?
Come on, it wasn't that bad.
What do you want?
We represent the Lollipop Guild, and we want you.
Gags about helium and test tube revenge, all in tonight's episode of The Big Bang Theory. And maybe if you listened closely enough tonight, you might have heard Eric Hansen laughing out there in the studio audience.
Well, you got to be on the set for tonight's episode, and you got to talk to some of the actors, too, right?
I did. I got to see it, and I've seen it a couple times now, but I knew which jokes were coming, and I still laugh tonight when I actually saw the show on TV, because whether you're hanging out with the actors themselves or watching their characters, the Big Bang apartment in Hollywood will fluctuate your funny bone.
In a hot, dense state that nearly 14 billion years ago expansion started. Wait.
In the middle of Hollywood's biggest studio, TV's number one comedic quartet is rehearsing.
All right, stand by.
It's pledge week, and they're trying to goose the ratings with a little controversy.
Four scientists and their rival.
When did National Public Radio start scraping the bottom of the barrel for its guests?
In a college cafeteria.
It helps, guys, if it's a blank stare.
Who'd have ever guessed that formula would spark a ratings explosion?
I don't know if I'd watch. You know, there's four smart, geeky guys and a pretty girl. Oh, who cares, you know? But it's so much more than that, and I guess that sort of speaks to us, yay, but I think it mostly speaks to the writing.
A careful combination of comedy and scientific tongue twisters.
It required the completion of 144 units of grad work and an original thesis.
Yes. Look this over and tell me what's unclear to you.
We'll all get a little dose from time to time of these insane, you know, spouting out formulas and that kind of jargon.
But 4 years ago, the first episode didn't bang. It fizzled.
It was a bumpy road early on. We did one pilot that was not great.
Penny, the girl next door, was too mean. The guys, too out there. So they made the geeks more lovable and tried again.
We were always careful of not making fun of the characters, so I guess we just didn't know how many geeks there really were out there.
13 million a week. But are the actors behind the dorky clothes as geeky as their characters?
We have cool moments, I'd like to think.
Yeah. And we don't have usually as smart of moments as the people we play,
oh,
you know?
That's never happened.
I don't consider anybody unintelligent on... Well, for the most part, I don't consider anybody on the show unintelligent, but...
Kunal does some dumb stuff.
I wasn't going to say it.
We're automatically 1,000 times cooler than the people we play on TV, just as soon as they say cut.
Because not one actor could really solve the formulas scribbled on the set.
Leonard and Sheldon's apartment is actually on the same stage here at the Warner Brothers lot as big productions like Casablanca back in the year. But right now, these are the guys that rule the roost.
The number one comedy among young adults is nominated for TV's biggest awards. Jim Parsons, who plays Sheldon, was even up for an Emmy.
It's odd. Not in a bad way, but it's definitely odd. There's nothing really to do except get a tux and show up.
Don't sell yourself short there, because you got a great tux.
I did have a nice tux.
You looked really good.
Thank you, Calvin Klein Collection.
The guy whose mannerisms are similar to his character, only much less brash, credits the writers for their success. The other guys agree.
Because they've really made these characters accessible to everyone, you know, and you can't have a show where it's just 1, 2, 3, joke, joke, joke. People actually have to care about these characters.
Yo, Raj, talk to me.
Writing enough jokes to fill a hit comedy is hard. Now try two. You see, the writers who give Sheldon and Leonard their lines also give Charlie and Alan theirs. 2.5 Men shoots next door, and one team writes both shows.
They're like the touchstone for as successful a contemporary comedy can be.
Between them, they've become Monday must-see. So what's next for the four friends focused on females and physics?
Well, I've never talked to another actor on any other show who's known less about what was coming up. I'm serious. You'd think that we had, you know, a cliffhanger central around here.
All they know is America loves geeks.
It took 2.5 hours to tape tonight's episode in Hollywood in front of a studio audience of about 300 fans. They did every scene at least twice, sometimes trying a different punchline. Sometimes an actor would forget his line or something like that, but they got through it all. And there were little things that were left out that just were too long for tonight's episode. But for the most part, it was exactly what we saw in Hollywood.
2.5 hours to shoot a 30-minute show. That's quite... condensed.
Exactly. They bang it right out. Yeah. We had pizza between a couple scenes, so that was kind of cool.
But you didn't get to talk to Penny.
We didn't. She was apparently nursing a cold, so they didn't want her talking any more than she needed to, so she was off limits, but the other guys were good.
A couple quick questions. You mentioned all the formulas that are written on the blackboards and stuff like that in their lab and things like that. Are they real formulas? I mean, do they really?
They are. They have a physicist on set who kind of makes sure that things are capiche with
other.
Yeah, exactly.
Physicists.
Make sure they aren't saying the wrong thing or something like that, so yeah.
You've got another TV show to talk about tomorrow, right?
We did. We did. As we were out in L.A., we went to another show. NCIS and its spinoff, NCIS Los Angeles, have become ratings powerhouses. Tomorrow night, we're going to show you around L.A.'s mission. We'll sit down with LL Cool J, who plays Sam, along with Kenzie, Eric, Nate, and Dominic. We've even found an Iowa tie behind the cameras. It kind of took us off guard. And you won't believe how short the actor who plays Hetty is if you watch that show. She comes up about to the bottom of my rib cage. She will be on the set.
You're
of
7 feet tall. Anyway.
Well, that too. It's all relative, I guess. We're on the set of the number one new show on TV, NCIS Los Angeles, tomorrow at 6 and 10.
Oh, that's going to be fun. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Eric. Yep.